Joe's Dominar Radio. It's 1810 at 0503 2022. It's a Saturday. It's a wonderful day. It's an amazing day. Although it's raining here in the UK, it's been raining all weekend. Hopefully the sun is out there where you are. But you know what? We are the sunshine of the weekend today. And also, and I got an amazing powerhouse coming on the show this evening. Mate, ladies and gentlemen, I am even worried how I'm gonna run this, you know, show today, because what, there's loads of energy coming through. It's the one and only, shall I say it, you know what, wait, I actually let her introduce herself anyway. Who do we have on the show today? Author of Avant Social. Go on. Let's hear the energy coming through.
It's the one and only energy goddess, MC Charlene in the building, all the way from Norway. Born in Cameroon, raised in Norway. I am glad to be here, Domino 9. This is going to be fun. Are you ready?
Oh my gosh, ladies and gentlemen, can you hear that energy coming through? The energy is vibrant. It's the one and only MC Charlene, AKA Energy Goddess, an award-winning Cameroonian international MC host based in Norway and all over the world, I should say, because you know what? There's nowhere you go and mention MC Charlene. It'll be like, oh my God, you know her as well. Yes, we do. She's here on Dominar Radio, gracing our presence on the show this evening. It's a big thank you for coming on the show this evening, MC Charlene.
Yeah, listen, I'm so glad to be here. It's fun. I'm in the UK and I'm here on Double Nine Radio. I mean, come on. Where else would I be? I'm glad to be here.
Fantastic. And you decided to come on a very juicy topic day and a very juicy one on 35 and social. As you know, we talk about mature dating and everything. We thought, you know what? We have a controversial topic happening on the show today. We thought, you know what? Who can we bring on? Who can we have on the show today to talk about this amazing topic? You know what? We're talking about dating. Do men have to pay your bills? I mean, when we talked about this topic and think, you know what? We should be talking about this evening. I don't know. I had different thoughts about it. I don't know. What is your take on this one? I mean, did it strike you as, you know, something we should talk about at all? Because initially, you know what, before we actually answered our question, we've been having shows at the start of the year talking about dating rules in 2022. That, you know, dating needs to change from what it is, you know, from last year, because the pandemic came and kind of like changed the whole outlook on how everybody thought dating was, because people became single, they couldn't go out, they couldn't mingle, kind of thing. You know what, so dating needed to change, the game had to change, kind of thing. So you know what, we've been talking about things about, I think last week we talked about should a woman been asking a man out, and we thought, you know what, let's put the man on the hot seat today. So we're asking, do men have to pay, you know, women's bills?
Well, actually, this is a really broad question. Okay, it's a really broad question for me. Do men have to pay ladies' bills? Yes, they do, and no, they don't. Okay, listen, if a man wants to pay your bill, it's up to the man. You know what I mean? I don't think ladies should go expecting that a man should pay their bills. I don't think that. You know, if you have your expectations, that's fine, but how can you grow up with a mindset that a man is supposed to pay for everything for you? No, a man has a choice. It's his money. The same way you can work, that's the same way a man can work. Don't you think so?
I agree.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm a man, you know.
Yeah, you're a man, yeah.
I am going to say, you know what, definitely agree with that. You know what I mean? But I'm sure other women out there will beg to differ and say, you know what, because we've had, you know, comments like, you know, if you can't take care of it, don't touch it, or
some
funny things like that. But I say, my response to that is, do you know what I mean? You know, we're going into a relationship, you know what I mean? You know, we're talking about relationships. People should not have an expectation of, you know, saying that someone should be looking after them. You know,
no, exactly.
Your parents are that's what your parents are for. But people will still argue and say, you know what? I want my man to be able to look after me. I want my man to be able to pay my bills.
Okay. Okay, listen, if you want your man to be able to pay your bills, that means you want to be traditional. That's the traditional way.
I love that.
You get what I'm saying? Yeah. You want to be traditional. Are you willing to be traditional? Are you willing to put on a skirt, go to the kitchen and cook, clean, wash, make sure his food is ready, make sure his coat is on a hanger waiting for him before he goes home, goes to work and comes back? Are you ready to massage his feet? Are you ready to be his maid? Because that's practically what being traditional is, if you ask me. The man is the breadwinner and the woman is just home taking care of everything. Are you willing to be traditional? If you're willing to be traditional, then that's fine. But if you're just here to eat the man's money and not doing it, I'm not gonna curse.
Don't curse, please. Mayday, mayday. No cursing on the show, please.
I'm not gonna curse. But if you're not going to be traditional, don't expect that from a man. I mean, that's why I always say communication is everything. When you meet a guy, let him express to him how you are. Like me, if I meet a guy and he's that guy that wants to, like, you know, I'll pay for this. I say, yes, please, thank you. More money in my pocket because I make my own money. I'll just save it, put it in my bank account, promote my business, build my business. If he wants to take care of me, I appreciate that. But I don't expect that of him. Let him be the one to say, don't worry, baby, I got you. Don't go with a mindset. That's a lazy mindset. That you go into a relationship expecting a man to do everything for you. What are you bringing to the table? That's the question.
Fantastic. Fantastic point you made there. I mean, I'm going to touch on 2 points, but I'm going to take it one by one. You talked about the cultural aspect of stuff. Do you want to be, you know, the cultural thing? You know, do you want to be like how the African home or African mentality is? I don't know. I stand corrected. As I mentioned as well, this number is 074-956-36899. You call us direct if you want to be part of the show this evening. But the thing I'm going to go quickly into is, like, you know, we talk about women. Let's talk about women in 2022. I want to go back in 2021. Or should I go back in 2021 a bit? Because women out there, would, you know, you have all those women going out, you know, posting on social media, you know, designer bag, designer this, designer that kind of thing. And they're like thinking to themselves, like, you know what? If any man is going to ask me out, you know, does she be able to afford this?
But why?
Is that a mindset? Should that be the mindset? Because you talked about, yeah, don't have a mindset of that mentality of a man trying to pay your bills all the time. But the thing is, are we saying that that's not the mindset of people out there at the moment? Because we have women out there, when they go to the restaurant, they're doing their Instagram, doing their that, you know, wearing their makeup, everything, you know what I mean? But a man that's possibly not driving or something, but guy's good looking, he's hard working, do you know what I mean? He's like, baby, you know what, I like you so much.
Yeah.
I want to be with you kind of thing. Are you saying to me, a woman, you know, would say, okay, you know what, let's give it a go? Or do women have certain standards?
You have to have standards.
Okay, here we go. We go somewhere.
No, you have to have standards. Somewhere. That's not what I'm saying. Okay. I have standards. Like, I'm this girl. If you don't open the door for me, I don't need to date you, because it shows me that you don't have that respect for me as a woman to do the little things. You understand? It's just opening the door. I care about little things. You understand? Buy me Gucci and Louis Vuitton. That's extra. I love that too. You understand? And you're going to do it if you're my man. Naturally, it would come to you. You understand? But if I'm like, listen, I saw a Louis Vuitton bag yesterday and I want that bag. That's now it's a different way. You're gonna say you're expecting him to do that. No.
Okay.
You
know. Okay. All right. Let me come at you again. Last week, right? We mentioned about I think it was a week before. I can't actually remember that topic. Where I mentioned about women. Some women, you know, have guys' numbers on their phone. They could have Tunde
one, Mugo two, Mugo three.
You listen to that show. Tunde one, Tunde Bill, no, Tunde Gas, Femi this.
I say something?
Yeah, please.
I think it has a lot to do with the society of where you're raised and where you're from.
Right.
Listen, I grew up in Norway. I've been in Norway for over 22 years.
Yeah.
I've learned. I work. I go to school. I have an education. You understand? So I can always take care of myself. So if a man cannot do anything for me, I will do it myself.
But a woman would argue, they would say, yes, I can take care of myself, but I want to feel like a man can take care of me as well.
But that's up to you. That's up to the man to be that way. And if you don't want that kind of man, keep it pushing, but don't come and expect. That's your forcing. You, listen, when we start pushing this mindset that men has to do this, have to do that, you put a lot of pressure on men, we would then affect them mentally. Let me know, be a social worker, because a social worker comes out. Yeah, you understand? Yeah. But listen, it has a lot of effect. I see on Instagram, girls talking about, well, man has to buy my blah, blah. What are you bringing to the table? What are you bringing to the table? You understand? If you meet a man that wants to do all those things for you, that's fine, but that's because he wants to do it.
Yeah. Okay, now, the question we asked, do men have to pay your bills, right?
Yeah.
So, now, let's...
Yes, please, darling, pay my bill.
Okay.
If you want to.
Okay, but does that, would that affect the commitment of a woman to a man if a man is not so forthcoming on paying those bills?
Listen, let me just say it this way. If I have a man, okay, and he doesn't have enough money to be in a relationship, I think you should be single. Okay, let me tell you something.
Okay.
Let me tell you something. If a man doesn't have money to be in a relationship, he should be single. Because it's not about taking care of the woman. It's about working together. If you don't have money to go out for dinner, should the woman now be paying for everything? That's another question. Mm. You know, you don't want to be in a relationship when you feel like you're a liability to your woman.
Where's the love? Where's love? Where's
listen,
the love?
Listen.
What
listen,
is the love?
I have mixed feelings. If this one is a different conversation. Because me...
But
like,
it's not the same conversation. No, because now, part of the bills could be, you know, you going out for dinner or something. Or maybe, you know, car broke down. And
it's understanding,
you know what
man.
I mean, things like that. So, I mean, you talk about a man should be able to do that. Obviously, yes, we would agree. But
yes,
you're in a relationship, you know, kind of thing. Is it not like
mutual
stuff?
Like,
you know what
like,
I mean?
Like in Norway, where everything is so expensive.
Yeah.
Why would I expect the man to pay all those things when he's making almost the same money as I'm making?
Okay.
It's not like in America when the class
what
is so...
What if he's making less money?
If he's making less money, we can talk. You okay. Take this, I take that.
Okay.
If that's wow. What I want.
MC Charlene is quite nice. Okay.
No. Okay. But that's the reality. Don't let social media fool you. In Europe, people make the same amount of money. Uh-huh. It's only this sugar daddy, sugar mama
very
thing
good.
There in Africa that people poor girls are running after men to be able to survive. No,
okay,
in Europe, there's
yes.
Education. Everybody has an education.
Okay.
Everybody works. So when you get into a relationship, you work together.
Amazing.
You understand? If the man chooses to take more of the house bill and pay more of the rent and pay more of the food, and say, babe, you can take the food stuff and stuff. Okay.
Okay.
That's working together.
Okay, fantastic. So coming back to the initial question, would that affect being not being able to be committed to this individual? Because if you now come across a guy who's willing to pay plus or minus all the bills, you know, would that affect the commitment you initially had with this man or something? You know what I mean? A man that's not willing to pay all your bills.
But why should a man, it's even funny for me to hear that a man is willing to pay all my bills. Because in Europe, that doesn't exist unless he's a millionaire. Because the bills here are not cheap. Going out to eat is not cheap. Only in Norway, house rent alone will slap you in the face. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
You know what I mean? So listen, we're in a relationship. If a man has enough money to do that, go ahead and do it. Okay. I don't have a problem. That means more money for me to save and take, even send it to my grandma that needs it. In the village,
right.
You understand?
Yeah.
But I will not go into relationship expecting that.
Okay.
And it will not change how I feel about you if you can't afford, because I chose to be with you, so I chose to accept what you bring to the table.
Amazing.
Do you get what I'm saying?
I get what you're saying.
Why would I not love you more?
Okay. I love that. Now, let me take it back to the initial question. I thought I had two points that you raised.
Okay.
So you talked about the cultural aspect. Mm-hmm. Of you know, if you expect the man to pay your bills, that means you have to be submissive in mm-hmm. a way, kind of thing. So
yeah.
Are we saying that if a man is not paying all your bills, you would not be submissive to this man?
No. What does it mean to be submissive?
I don't know. You tell me.
Like me, I personally, I'm a boss chick. You understand?
Okay.
So being submissive is is hard. It's something that I have to work my way into because I've been independent for so long. So I'm a boss. I know how to take care of myself.
Okay.
It's very hard for me to let somebody in to come and control me and tell me how things should be done because I've been doing it by myself since I was 16 years old.
Right.
So when you come into a relationship expecting me to be submissive, what are you doing back? Are you being submissive to me back?
So they should be paying all your bills then?
No, not really.
Okay.
Okay. Listen. Because they cannot be paying off my bills if they want me to be submissive, because it's not possible. I am a workaholic. Uh-huh. I like to work for my money.
Okay.
So I can never be a housewife.
Yeah.
You can never say put me in the house.
Do you have to be a housewife to be submissive to your husband or your? No. We're not even talking because it's not a marriage show. To your boyfriend for
no.
Instance.
There's different way of being submissive.
Okay.
You know, being submissive is letting the man being the man and you being
the woman.
not in that way.
Okay.
You know, like let's say sometimes you allow the man to take more decisions.
Yeah.
Okay. Uh-huh. He comes to you for advice, you're his backbone, but you allow the mind to come up with ideas and make more decisions.
Yep.
You get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Yeah. Me, I will allow you to come here, but not make decisions of me until I feel safe and feel secure. I know that if I let you handle it, you will do it correctly.
Mm.
So me being submissive is gradual. It's a process because I'm natural boss.
Mm.
I can take care of myself. I control everything. I control my empire. So when a man is coming into my empire,
yes.
If I'm accepting you into
the
my
queen
empire,
has spoken. Yes.
If I'm accepting you into my empire,
yes.
Then you first have to understand where I'm coming from and how you gradually have to make me trust you. Now, listen, you can handle this business.
Mm.
Let me sit back and relax. And that takes time, you know. And a lot of men don't understand that. When they get into the relationship, they just want to say, sit and you sit, stand and you stand. No, be for you, because no, be you to pay my bills.
I mean, I love the point you're making. This
I gotta go to work.
I love the point you're making. Mm-hmm. So now, okay, let's jump to the fact that, okay, you know, this man is paying all your bills now, for instance, right?
Yes, I'll still be working.
You still be working. Do you think women are then, because if a man is paying all your bills, it comes with certain, you know, factors or caveats and stuff where the man will possibly want to be a bit more imposing.
That's the problem.
Is that a problem?
That's a big problem.
Okay.
Because when they start paying all your bills, it'll be like one day when people are arguing, they will say, you this nincompoop that I pay everything for you.
Okay.
They will, no, wait, let
I
me
apologize for the language.
No, they don't understand that one. This is preaching. They'll be saying, I do this for you, I did that for you, I pay your bills,
uh-huh.
I own you. Do you want a man to own you? The last thing a woman should want is for a man to say that they own you where they did not even give birth. Even your parents don't own you. You understand? But a man that pays all your bills will feel like you are his property, which makes you lose your value as a woman.
Right.
You understand?
Right.
Because you now become a product that is owned by somebody.
Mm.
And the worst part of that is when he's ready to throw you away,
mm-hmm.
and you have nothing because he has been doing everything,
mm-hmm.
a lot of women find themselves in the streets after living a luxury life.
Mm.
Because of those you be enjoying, be chopping the man's money, be eating the man's money.
I hear you.
You know what I'm saying?
I hear you. But, you know, some women will still argue and say, you know what? I know, MC Charlene, I hear what you're saying.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I mean... But I like being taken care of.
I like being taken care of too.
I want my man to, you know, I don't want to stress. I just want to wake up and see my phone bill is paid. My car bill is paid.
That's,
you know,
fantastic.
You know, but they will still argue and say, oh, why can't a man pay my bills? You know, because honestly, what we're talking about today, I mean, there was a topic, online where an individual, I mean, it's a bit similar. Where an individual did a post online talking about you going to see a man and the man should pay your cab fare. And I'm thinking to myself,
that
like,
was madness.
I don't understand that. I don't understand that because and this individual is trying to justify it, like, pay your cab fare. But anyway, let's go for a short break and we're going to find out what MC Charlene thinks about that online post, about that woman talking about, you know, the man should pay my cab fare if I go see her. Stay locked on, stay locked in. It's your host, Dub and I, on Dub and I Radio. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to Dub and I Radio. It's 1832-0503-2022. Yes, you know, you're the right station, right place, right time. We got the amazing energy goddess. Oh my gosh, the energy is so overwhelming as well. She's amazing. Coming through with energy all through as well. I'm thinking to myself, where is my Red Bull? Where is my energy drink? How can I keep up with this amazing energy goddess coming through right here on Dub and I Radio on 35 and Social, talking about an amazing topic. You know, your dating, should men be paying your bills as well? Welcome back, energy goddess, the MC Charlene.
Ooh, gee! And we are back. Listen, before we continue, I have to say one thing. There's one thing that is very important here. In a relationship, all couples do things differently, right? All couples do things differently. That's why it's very important that when you are in a relationship, both of you have an understanding. Because sometimes there's no such way as a wrong way or a right way. It's all about how you individuals have come together and chose to do in your relationship. Okay?
I mean, I hear,
am I wrong?
I hear MC Charlene trying to be, you know, not political there, you know.
No,
you know. She's speaking like a politician, you know. Saying,
no,
you know what,
no.
You know that no. All relationships have. Yes, they do.
They do.
But before we actually get too excited and go into that, we will come back to that as well. Before the break, we were talking about that, you know, post that, I don't want to say the lady, because everyone probably know who I'm talking about. You know, the post that was online talking about a man has to pay your cab fare or whatever, transport fare, if you go and see him. I don't know. I'm in two minds. You know what? I don't mind doing that. If a lady's coming to see me, mm-hmm. or, you know, I would call an Uber, you know, mm-hmm. do an Uber and do it standardly.
Yes.
But don't come at me.
And expect
and tell me that it's like a rule, it's a given that you have to do that. For me, that's a bit like, no.
Honestly speaking, yeah. Sorry. Listen, I was really, like, shocked. I was like, is this how you do people think in Nigeria? Is this like a Nigerian thing?
I've never
heard of that.
Okay, Mayday, you, wait, Mayday.
No,
it's
stop
not,
it.
It's not only
Africa,
Nigeria.
Africa. Okay.
Mayday. It's not only Africa as well. It was MC Charlene that said that. It was a double nine, just in case. You know,
no,
like,
listen. Yeah. Listen. How can you say, as a woman, open your mouth and say that, and man should pay your cab fare to a date that you are going to? You are going to sit there and eat with a man.
I know. It's a bit shocking.
How is it possible?
It's a bit shocking.
So he's going to pay for the food, okay? Probably drinks too. Mm-hmm. You're going to sit there with him. Mm-hmm. What are you bringing to the table? Your looks? Did he chop looks?
I hear you.
Looks now, money.
I'm not sure.
Let me continue. The girl had an argument that, oh, hair costs money. Mm. Do you know how expensive it is to be a Lagos babe in Lagos? What? Who sent you to be a Lagos baby in Lagos? They put now by force.
Exactly.
Live according to your means, baby.
Yeah. I mean,
you know?
I hear that. But, you know, I don't know if you read the comments that came on the
post. I did. I commented there. People were like, thank you, MC Charlene.
But you had some people agreeing and saying, yes, you know.
There's nothing wrong with that, double nine. Mm-hmm. If a guy wants to pay my cab fare,
yeah.
That's sweet.
Yeah.
Thank you. I appreciate it. Mm-hmm. But I can pay for my own cab fare if 100%. I want to.
I'm
not going to expect you to do it.
Yeah.
But the gesture that comes from you is quite sweet.
It is.
It's not going to make me think anything else of you if
yeah.
you don't.
Yeah.
That's the thing I'm saying.
I hear that.
Yes.
I hear that. But he made a big, you know, hoo-ha about it, saying that, you know what, a man should, you know, pay. You know, you should be expecting to pay that. And that's my own issue with that. Do you know what I mean?
Me too.
You don't have an expectant... you know, thing to say, you know what, he must do it, and saying, oh, what, you're never going to go back and see him. I think it's a really bad message being passed on
it's
to society.
It's very terrible.
It is.
Not only are you putting these young boys that are struggling to survive themselves, now you'll be adding pressure to them, because social media has a lot of influence. Okay, you're adding pressure to these young boys that are just struggling to even pay their house rent.
Yeah.
They want to ask a girl out that they find attractive or sweet.
Amazing.
Now you'll be feeling pressured because you have to pay their tax fare. You pay for the food. What are you? Listen, I know. See,
I love that point. I love that point you just made.
What
as
is
well.
That?
Because now, you know, you talk from from the perspective of the boys, of the men who are trying to, you know, get on in life and trying to, you know, get a girl they
yes.
like, kind of thing. But now let's look at it from the female perspective. Now, Phil, the young ones coming up, seeing all this on social media, saying that
terrible,
saying that, you know what, yeah, a man has to pay for your fare. You know, a man's going to pay for your bills, blah blah blah. It's going to send a horrible message, because
yes.
now what you're going to be thinking is like, you know what, we might as well just, you know, don't, if I can't leave my house, I mean, if you don't pay me, I can't leave my house. So what is the difference between a prostitute?
No.
I didn't want to say the word.
I wrote there on the blog, that right. I said, just become an escort. That's practically the same
Boom.
Thing.
Yeah.
That's what I wrote.
Yeah.
Just become an escort. That's yeah. practically the same thing.
Exactly that.
Because you're just, somebody's paying you for your time. You're being an escort. Just
yeah.
accept that.
Exactly that.
Okay.
Exactly that.
Okay. This gold digging mentality has to stop. It's getting too much for me. It's getting too much for me. If I find a man that can pay everything, do it. That's up to you.
Yeah.
But it doesn't mean that I can't afford it. If I cannot afford it, I'll tell you that I cannot afford it.
Yes.
I remember there was a time I went on a date. I decided, like, I can pay the bill. I don't mind. You understand?
You paid all the bill.
Wait.
Okay.
The guy got upset with me.
I was very excited. I was like, when you asked
me. Yeah, I've paid a bill before. I've paid a bunch of bills before. Like,
when she asking me out, Mike, you know what I mean? I want to go on that date.
Paid bills before. Yes, I've dated guys who worked at McDonald's.
Oh, wow.
And you understand that when I just finished study, I dated a guy who worked at McDonald's. It was an amazing guy. Yeah. But he was a student.
Yeah.
And he worked. He didn't have money.
Yeah.
So when we went out, I was like, don't worry, I got it.
Yeah.
That's because I know what kind of man is sitting in front of me.
Yeah.
He has value.
Yeah.
You understand?
Yeah.
He's a good. I see potential. I see a future. I see somebody that is going to do amazing things.
Amazing.
You understand?
You see the potential.
Yes.
Now, again, you see, I love the point you're giving me this amazing evening as well. So are we saying that the society has lost the ability, should I say ability, or the character of being able to look at an individual and say, you know what, maybe he's got potential and maybe I can stick with him and maybe build something together with him?
Yeah.
Because now that's not happening anymore. Love is now finance, is now money. You know, people now replace love with money.
Yeah, it's,
where's the society going?
I think it's in the world of social media that people replace love with money. In the real life, there's a bunch of people that don't even know what Instagram is, and they're living perfectly. It's a world of social media. Honestly speaking, okay, when I was younger, okay, I'll be 30 next month,
no.
And I'm still looking beautiful and cute and looking like I'm 16,
she looks like 21,
baby.
Mate. 21,
you know
what's mate.
That? So 16. Which
oh,
six,
sorry, 16. Correct. 16. Yeah. 1-6.
So listen. When I was younger, I didn't have any problem dating a man that you're working here, you're doing this. I don't have a problem. Even if I saw potential, I don't have a problem.
Yeah.
But let me just say something, add to what you said.
Yeah.
When a woman is getting to a certain age,
okay,
you want that stability.
Okay.
You want that man that you know that I'm ready to get married. Mm-hmm. I'm ready to have babies.
Yeah.
Getting married, having babies, living together costs.
Yes.
You get what I'm saying?
Okay.
You want a man that you know that, okay, I got my own, he's got his own, mm-hmm. we're building.
Mm-hmm.
At in a certain age, women think about that.
Mm-hmm.
The financial part is important.
Okay.
So
yeah.
That's not, we cannot exclude that. No,
no,
that's not what I'm saying.
Yeah.
You understand? Like me in this age, I don't think that I can see myself trying to be with somebody that is still trying to make it. No, because that would put a lot of pressure on me.
Yeah.
Who where? Because I've already, I'm where I'm growing.
Mm-hmm.
I'm building.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I want somebody that we can take what he has, what I have, and we build it and create an empire. I don't want somebody that I'll come now and we'll start going from square zero. We'll be eating out of cans. You understand?
I hear that.
Do you get what I'm saying?
I hear that.
So there's nothing wrong with setting those standards for yourselves, but don't go and say, pay my transport.
I know. I've been asked. I mean, again, you know, I love the great points you're making this evening, and
mm-hmm.
you know, it's quite wonderful. I mean, you talk about looking at the perspective of an individual who has gone through a stage. Like you go through a stage where you're not looking at potential anymore.
Yeah.
You go through a stage where now it's more about reality. What do you have to offer me?
Yes.
Kind of thing. But do you think that that's sometimes misconstrued, where individuals are more reliant on individuals? Because now, what I see personally,
you're reliant if you don't have anything to do yourself.
Mm.
That's the difference.
Mm.
Yes.
Okay.
Listen, I have a job. I pay my rent.
But
I pay everything.
People will still argue. Because honestly, people will still argue. Because some women still say, you know what? I'm living with a man. For instance, they're moving with a boyfriend or girlfriend, whatever. And they want to keep their own money rather than add to the bills in the house.
Listen. It's up to my man, okay? If I get with a man, we see the financial differences. If you make 60% more than I do.
You're speaking very sensibly, but I don't think a lot of women do that.
No, but that's because I come from a different background.
Mm.
You understand? I don't have the poverty mindset.
Wow.
You understand? No. A lot of women in certain backgrounds have the poverty mindset.
Wow.
That's what I call it.
Keyword, poverty mindset.
Yes,
she
poverty
said it.
Mindset. You're always hungry for other people's stuff.
Mm.
Instead of building your own.
Shots fired. Yes.
You understand? Poverty mindset. That's it. I have my own. I would love to have a man that says, oh, let me do everything for you.
Yeah.
Sure. But that's the man's choice. You understand?
Yeah.
I don't expect you to say, do everything. But I expect you to have your own. I expect you to work together with me.
Yeah.
You understand? But there are things that you, as a man, know that you're supposed to do. I don't need to tell you. You see the woman you're with. You see the standard of her living. You see how she carries herself. You already know what you should do at, as a man. And if that woman has to teach you, then you guys are on different lanes. Do you get what I'm saying?
I mean,
naturally, a man will know what woman he's carrying with him.
I agree. I love the point you're making. Again, you say a man naturally should know as well. But you also talk about the poverty mindset. Now, isn't there a balance of where what they're expecting to as what the man can do kind of thing? Because you're saying a man should know certain things. Yes, there's some basic things that a man would know as a standard kind of thing. But we have individuals out there, you know, especially some ladies out there, who are in the Instagram world, the, you know, social media craziness, and want to be like their friend, because their friend is probably posting pictures of being in I don't know, Monte Carlo or south of France or something like that. Is that you know?
But they don't know what that friend has done to get there.
Exactly. Then their mind, the expectation of what the man should be doing is like measured to that as well.
Yeah, that's tragic. That's women who don't have their own minds. You understand? Women who don't have self-confidence and self-respect. You understand? When you don't know who you are, you will always be looking for people. You understand? You always be looking for what people have and trying to have what they have. No, you have to build your own. Listen, don't get me wrong. Sometimes I see this girl on a private jet enjoying life, chopping life, as we say in Pidgin English, chopping life. I'll be like, damn, I wish I was on that flight. By the same time, I know my time is coming when I get there by myself. Okay? And if I have a man next to me, we're going there together.
Amazing.
You get what I'm saying?
Amazing.
You understand? If that man can afford to put me on that flight, he can afford me to put me on that flight, and I will say, hallelujah, amen, Lord Jesus, I have a man with money that also loves me. That's just a plus. It's plus.
Again, love, the word love, it's almost non-existent plus. Anymore. You know, it's almost like it's fading out. Because now
love is not fading out. It's social media that is making it look like it. This Ashao that they say in Nigerian language.
Yeah.
I mean this.
Yeah.
Can
yeah.
I say prostitute yes, on
you,
radio?
You already said it anyway.
But I said it in Yoruba. I don't think many people.
You just said it in English anyway as well. But carry on.
So, even prostitutes need love too. Yeah.
Okay.
Let me tell you, a lot of these babes. Instagram babes that you see on Instagram.
Do they know what love is though?
No, let me tell you, some of them go to bed crying. Trust me, I'm a social worker. I study psychology. Trust me. Wow. The things they have to do for that money, you wouldn't want to be part of it. Okay? Shopping. Some of them have mental problems. Some of them are on drugs. Some of them are depressed. Don't let Instagram fool you. Some of them behind... Instagram, if you make man jump from the river.
I mean, yeah, the social media gives paints a lifestyle of where people are living really well kind of thing, which puts pressure on certain individuals
as well.
You know, where the expectant level of what a man should be giving you goes up. That's where we come up with the question, should a man be paying your bills? Because on social media, you're seeing this female going on holiday, going on breaks, going on spa sessions and things like that, but you don't know what and how, you know, sacrifices they had to do to get to that point as well. But again, you know, I still come back to the word love. I think love is fading. The real love.
Love is not fading. Love is fading on social media. But even those girls need love. You cannot survive without love. Okay, you need that partner. Do you know what it feels getting back home and knowing that your best friend is there to hold your hand and cuddle you. I love to cuddle. I can't imagine not having a man that doesn't want to cuddle with me.
I hear that. But the thing is, the question we're asking today is because it's so common. Women have this expectation of a man paying the bills. But the thing is, so if a man cannot pay that bill, that means they can't love him. So the love is almost equated to the money.
Yeah, that's the poverty mindset that I'm talking about. That's the poverty mindset. And a lot of women are actually not like that. There are a lot of boss chicks out there.
Wow.
Listen, if I meet a man that says, Charlene, I want to pay all your bills. Listen, what is it that you need? I'll be like, hey, this is the list. I need this. I need that. I'll give you a list. I say, thank you, baby. I appreciate you. Because that is coming from you. You are choosing to do that.
Right.
That means that I cannot do it myself. But you are seeing me and you see that maybe I need help. So you are offering to help me. That's a good man.
Yeah.
Okay? But I will never come to you and tell you that you're supposed to give me transport fare. You're supposed to pay my house. Say, now you born me. Are you my father?
Amazing.
What? I could never. But I will tell you that you're supposed to open the door for me. One I will tell you. I will tell you that it's natural that when I cook, you clean. You understand? Those are the things I will tell you. Understand?
She just said, when you cook, you clean. Okay.
You understand? That's partnership.
Partnership, yeah.
Do you get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Partnership.
Yeah.
But like I said before, every relationship that you go into is all about communication.
100%.
And understanding.
Yes.
You understand? You know,
yes,
doesn't want a man that can pay all her bills? Ladies want that. But if you are that kind of woman, make sure that you're working. Make sure that you have your own. Make sure that he's doing it from his heart. So they will not say, I did this for you. I did that for you. You're such a lazy woman. All you know do is sit around and open legs. You understand?
I mean, I hear that. I hear that a lot, you know. but the thing we see here is, you know, The social media, I think, is a problem.
The social media is a problem.
Social media is a problem. It's a problem where it portrays a lifestyle that's almost sometimes non-existent. You know,
it's not existent.
We have individuals who post, "Oh, my man got this for me," but they probably just,
argued and fight to.
Or even borrowed it from someone else to just take that picture, kind of thing.
Yeah.
Portraying a different kind of lifestyle to say, you know what, this is what I'm enjoying. This is what I'm, getting on with.
Let me tell you something. There was a time where I really had problem paying my house rent, especially when I was a student 2 years ago.
Yeah.
I struggled a lot. But you could never see that amazing. I was struggling on social media.
Amazing.
But I was having a hard time, you know. But you can't see that on social media.
Yeah. Yeah.
So that's why if you follow social media,
amazing.
Well, I have to tell you that you are a mumuman. That's what they say in Pidgin. That means you're dumb.
Yeah, you're right.
If you follow people's life on social media. I didn't come on social media to say, oh, I'm really having financial issues right now. I really help. I really need help.
Yeah.
You don't see that.
No.
You don't see when I'm struggling and crying on my bed because I feel alone. You don't see that. Only see me smiling and say, what's up, it's the energy goddess, what's going on? You know what I'm saying? That's all you see.
Yeah.
So don't let social media fool you.
Yeah.
Even Kim Kardashian, that is always there posting nude every 24/7. That girl is the biggest crier of all of them. Don't you think she has problem?
Of course.
And she also works really hard.
Yeah, she does.
You know?
Yeah.
So don't let it fool you.
I mean, great point, MC Charlene. You know, you're quite right, you know, because social media portrays a lifestyle where a lot of people follow it and at the end of the day start making demands or expectations.
Imagine.
I mean, for example, again, bringing it back again, the lady that was talking about, you know, a man must pay my taxi fare. You know, a woman who listens to that, or a young girl who listens to that, you know, would have that as a maybe a rule to say, you know what, if you can't pay me this, if you can't buy me that, you might as, you know, forget it.
You will remain single forever for the rest of your life if you have that barbaric poverty mentality that a man is supposed to pay my this, pay my that, pay. Now, he born you. Did he birth you? No.
Exactly.
Let him have the choice. I've had many men pay for my transport fee. Many sent a car to come and pick me up, you know, bought my flight ticket. It's not that I can't afford it.
Yeah.
It comes from the man.
You didn't
That's what's
it,
beautiful about it. Because he chooses to. You understand? I cannot call him. I'm like, yeah, I want to come to dinner with you. Remember to pay my taxes fee. I'll be like, dude. Like, what kind of woman is that?
I know. It's amazing. I mean, for me, the question or the answer to the question, for me, I don't think you should expect
that
should be paying your bills. You know,
there are certain things you should expect, but not that one.
Not that one. As MC Charlene has spoken, the energy goddess, giving us some raw vibes. It's an amazing evening. Mm-hmm. She's an amazing. She's been wonderful. I can't wait to have her back on the show this evening. But before we say goodnight to our listeners this evening, I want to ask, you know, the final question. Do you think man should be paying women's bills?
If he wants to, he's welcome to.
I told you. At least I think Charlene is going for political office.
No!
She's a look at our political answer. But I like it anyway.
Do we have a choice in life?
Yes, we do.
Yeah. Listen, a man, it's natural for the man to be the provider. Mm. It's natural. It's in a man's DNA.
Fantastic.
To be the provider.
Fantastic.
So automatically, he already knows the things he's supposed to do.
Mm-hmm.
You understand?
Yeah.
So he knows. And you know your place as a woman.
Mm-hmm.
When you guys come together
and
have an understanding, things are going to flow.
Mm-hmm.
You understand? But you coming into a relationship with all this poverty mindset, you throw him off.
Amazing.
Even if he wanted to buy you that Rolls Royce, he will not buy it again, oh.
Amazing. I mean, a big thank you to Charlene. She's coming through, being an amazing role model, I think, out there. Saying it how it is, giving it raw to you, and letting you make your own choices as well. I mean, she made a very valid point there, that a lot of individuals have different ways of dealing with stuff in relationships. You have to know what works best for you.
Mm-hmm.
Expecting a man to pay your bills or to do certain things for you does come with a bit of baggage as well, because it comes with a bit of demands that maybe you can't attach to or even give into as well. It also can affect your mental health. Rightly, you know, MC Charlene pointed out as well. Again, it's your choice, but make the right choice for yourself as well. And also, as MC Charlene rightly pointed out as well, don't follow everything you see on social media. There's a lot of facade out there as well, because it can be detrimental to your self as well. Don't remain single all through 2022. So, MC Charlene, what should we expect from you in the coming future? What is bubbling? What is cooking? What is vibing? Because you know what? We can't wait to see you performing again. We heard something about maybe you'll be performing sometime in London soon as well. How true are those rumors? Oh, do we all keep it under the hat at this moment in time?
Listen, there are not that many female MC hype queens here.
Woo!
You know what I'm you understand?
Yeah.
So MC Charlene is here.
She's here.
Take over, baby.
Oh, my word.
Because I see the male taking over the stages, hosting all the Afrobeat shows. And I'm here to say, ladies can do it too. The energy goddess is ready. What's up, UK?
Oh, my
What's
word.
What's up?
She's coming through. She's coming through.
Book me right now.
She's coming through. Make sure you're following her on Instagram as well. She's going to be announcing some amazing dates coming shortly into the UK, doing some great things as well.
Yeah.
Vibing as well. Trust
me.
If you haven't seen her perform, you ain't seen nothing yet as well.
Yes.
All the men performing, doing some MC thing, MC Charlene is here to take over.
Do you know what I mean?
Watch out, she's coming through. MC Charlene, it's been amazing to have you on the show this evening.
I can't wait
to have you back. It's been so wonderful. It's been vibrant. It's been great.
Thank you. It's been
so, so amazing. I think you've actually given me an energy level as well. I've got the energy vibe from you this evening as well.
Guys, remember to follow me on Instagram, that's MC Charlene Official. Check out my website, MC Charlene Official.com, to read more about me and know what I'm about. Okay, love you guys. Thanks for having me in Double Nine. I appreciate you.
Fantastic, ladies and gentlemen. Stay locked on, stay locked. It's your host, Double Nine, on Double Nine Radio. It's me, Fed of Ivan Social, with the amazing MC Charlene. As you know, we've got some amazing vibes coming your way this evening. Trust me, you don't want to miss the great tracks we have here on the show. We still got MC Charlene in the house. Me never know, but my head some hyper things coming through. Stay locked in. This is your host, Double Nine, with MC Charlene on Double Nine Radio.